Let's try something funny, because Alice in Wonderland is very funky and crazy, I think. And I think it will be nice if I put not a flip just right. I want it to be a little funky. I hope you can see it. This is straight and this is going that way. And now I have made one, but let me give you I think I just make a new one. So what I did was I will just measure how wide my page will be, and I cut it. So that's step one. Then I looked what corner I just want to do. So I just leave a little bit here and I leave a little bit on that side, and then I make a mark where my flippity flop will be, and in the same time I check how far I want it to be on top of here. So I just eyeball it. Now first we are going to make a flippity flop. Now it's easy for me to use the first fold, the first line. So I make my fold line and then I cut it. So I have our fold line. Oh, just stay here. And this can be just a little shorter. So that's first, and we already have drawn our line, how far it goes, and then we cut that off. And then we have a nice, perhaps you can see it like this better, then it's going that way. I really like it. And yeah, so this is going to be here. Make sure you are having enough room for that. I think I am going to glue this first down. I like it to be a little funky. Do something crazy. Yeah. So line it up. Now I do like when I have another one, perhaps on this side, but then I like it to be, of course, in another triangle. So I think I will need another piece, because I already used this one. So I think, we use the same size as this one. So make a mark and cut it. Then I just flip my page around, and I hope you will see what I do. And if I am still on frame, also, let's see. I will line this paper up and then I will see. I can make it over top. So don't go over that black one, and here just enough. Yeah, so let's see. just not over there and not over here. So first I want to make my line, my mark for the flippity flop, and then I will see how far I want to go. Just about the same as the last one. Just eyeball it, but you can measure if this is the same size. So let's do it again. Make our flippity flop, and I use the first one, and then I cut it shorter. It's a little small, but it's okay, it's just a flippity flop. And then I cut this part also shorter. Okay. And then if I will line this up, let's go crazy. Then let me see. Hey, what just happened? Oh, bummer. I made the wrong size. But hey, we can peel it off. See? It's that simple. Yeah, we want to make this side. No problem at all. Let's glue it on this side. Let's see, this is... I definitely want to see this one on top. Otherwise it don't have any effect if you don't see it. So yeah, here it lays very nice. So you see now, let's make this one just for the short moment. You see? And I think it will really pop out when it's all decorated, and I really like it. Yeah, like it. Now, let's find our way to design paper. Yeah, let's do this. Let's see. I think of something, and for the closure for this page, so let's see if I can explain it to you. Now, let's see, let's put this just for the moment away. Before I glue all my design paper on, I was thinking about how do I close it. Do I use a magnet? That's boring, but it can. It's an option. But I like to use a little, not a ribbon, but a magnetic closure. And therefore I am going to use this ribbon. So I put some tape on and I hope it will work. So I need one at this side. So that's one, and I need one at this size. So okay, now I first going to glue my design paper on. I really hope it will work out. I really have the camera really close by. Let's see. Oh, other way. Yeah, that's better. Otherwise, I don't know if I am always on the right side. So this is my background. Yeah. And okay, let's do it all. So I don't must be messed up. Otherwise, I really need to do all the pages again. So let's do it. Right at one time. Oh my god. I hope I manage. With no mistakes. Oh my god. Thumbs crossed. Light a candle up. Okay. Now I think I am going further with the closure first, and then do, so this is what you see underneath, and then I want the first one, I hope it's the middle, is it? Yeah, just about there. Then I am going to, let's see, what's wisdom? Do I have wisdom? No, I don't. Let's see. Let's use some tape. Yeah. And peel it off. And then I am going to use, yeah, this glue is good enough. Yeah. Now I line it up on top here, and then I hope this one's large enough. This is going to be on top, and what do I see? I see that this is going to be a little off because it's round, of course, but still can do it. Okay, I round it up. Let's try it again. Okay, give it a little push. So the whole cookie is really tight. Yeah. Okay, that's the first one. Yeah, I'm crazy, I know. Now the second one. Let's see what we are going to do. First, I am going to put the magnet on, of course. Then she knows where it comes. Now, I never did this before, so please forgive me if I am not that quick, or if I'm not um, Let's see, the black one's going to be under. So I think I am just gluing the magnet on the ribbon. Like that. Stay put, please, 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 please. Yeah. Okay. I'll take another piece of tape. Peel it off if you can. Oh my god, yes. Yes, 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 yes. And I think I just wound it up like this. Pray for me. Then I use the other cookie to become there, and then the other one, and I like to use just a little extra tape. So the glue can be really good attached to another. Okay, and now we are going to put this on top here. And we push and 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 push. Did this work out? I really hope so. I think I, when it's all finished, I put some little clamps on it. But for now, let's see. This goes down. And then, oh. Yay, it worked! Yes, 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 yes! I hope I don't have it too tight, but let it dry. So let's continue with our pages. Yeah. I picked these papers out for this page because the other one, we already did the blue one. Do you remember the first page? The first page is also blue. So I wanted to keep the blue again coming back on this side. So that's the reason why I picked the blue one. I turn it around. Oh, and a quick tip how I cut these papers very fast and easy is just grab a piece of paper and line it up like this. So, and let's take your pencil and mark it, and then cut it just a little smaller. And for the other one, the other side, just pick what you just cut out and place it again on design paper and cut it out. And not too good size, no, do it on two opposite sides, so you have it in how you call it? A mirror in the opposite side. Here you call it a spiegelbeeld, but in English I don't know if it's the right word for it. But okay, you know what I mean. Okay. Okay, now I want to make two little pockets. And oh, this is going to be this way. And where do I like it? On top? Or on here? What do you think? I think I do one here. So I can, yeah, let's do that. Let's go crazy. So one on top of here. So when it's completely dry, I can use a little card, just a little tuck spot, but it's not dry yet, but you'll know how it looks like. And the other one, I think I do it on here, so because if you open this and then make a card, it's nicer to put a photo on this side, so I think I want to glue this one on top. And it's just a little tuck spot. It's not a big pocket. It's just a little tuck spot. Yeah. Okay. That's enough for another little card. Okay. And now I have just one more, and do I like it, or I leave this for a nice photo? Let's decide later. But for now, this is going to be very nice! Oh my god! It worked! I really love it! Now, it is an option to cut out another one, so it's not that black. I think I do it. I cut two more of the cookies and I place it on. Yes, I love it. Thanks for watching. Just a quick close-up view how this page turned out. And this is magnetic, and you just squeeze it from each other, and there's not enough room for if you're leaving photos, of course. So this opens up, and yes, I did the background. Yeah, really like it. And on the front, there's a little pocket, and this flips open to the bottom, and then again a nice little tag, and this goes up, and lots of place for photos. And this I leave it plain for, so you can leave nice photos. And I really like how it turns out. It's just a little funky, and that's all about Alice in Wonderland. I like it. Thanks for watching. So let's get to the next page. The next page is on the back of this one. And we are first going to make a total flip. Let's see, the hinge on this side. So I wanted to flip it to the left, so the hinge is going to be on this side. So let's make a measurement for this page. This is going to be on this side. So, yeah. make a mark on how far this may go. So a little less. And then I see that I just have this so I can... Yeah. When you do also have just a little leftover, then you can decide if you are cutting this or make a fold line with it. So we have another pocket. So I decide that I make a pocket on this side. So when this is on top here, flips over to the left, and then we have a side pocket. Ah, okay, nice. Nice, 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 nice. So let's glue this on. Do a magnet. Yeah. So I don't forget. And then on the pockets. That is done. So, and then on top, I have something in my mind. So, but that I will do later. Now, I think I am going to make this paper on the bottom. And I think it's just a little smaller. To start. Okay. Okay. Now, I like to use the same for this one, so it will come back, and I like that when I use a small pocket. To use my little cutter for the smaller things. I think it's more handy. What size it was? This one, yeah. So okay, glue it on. Yeah, okay. background of this one. Let's see. I think this will fit. Or this one. Then this is pretty much the same color, and this will pop up a little more, so I like this one better. So let's give it a mark, a little smaller. Where's my mark? Oh, there. Glue it on, and then we can close our pockets. Okay, now we can tuck something in, but I first let the pocket dry for a second. Now, at the inside, oh, I moved it around too much. Stay. At the outside, I was the other day, I was wearing the other tools in my, how you call it here in the Netherlands. Oh, my battery is just finished. I just plugged in the charger, otherwise I do filming with no battery. That's not nice. So what I was saying, I was just in my local store, I call it the dollar store, it's called Action here in Holland, and I found these nice pockets, and I think, oh yeah, this I'm going to buy and use as just a little pocket, and I think it looked nice, I guess. And so what I did is I just put a little black paper in, so the cards will slide easier in and out, so that gives not a struggle, and I glue a little thing on, a little sticker. This is a sticker, so I think it's nice. So I think this is going to be on the left, and I'm right-handed, so I think it's easier that I give it that way. Yeah, so I just glue this on top, and yeah, I think I do. But for the background, we are going to use some paper, of course. But what paper do I like? We can use this one. I cut a little off. For just the rounds, the bottom and the top. So what I do is measure how far this goes. And the stripes are handy for this time. So I Okay, now I think I am glue this first down. So the wet of this card will come a little back, and also the wet on this. This on top. Yeah. Okay. Now, then the background, I think I am going to use this one here. So I measure, line it up like that, and then this will be let's grab the little one. Okay, let's measure it nice. Now this comes over there. Yeah. Yes. Okay. Now, smooth it all up. And glue it in here. Okay. Yep, check it. This is the good size. And then this is going to be on top. And I think later on I decide if I do just an extra embellishment. But that I will do with my glue gun. But let's see. I like this, but I like to have, let's see, this is going to be there and there. I like to give it some extra finish. So what I do, oh my god, she just cut in these nice cards. Let's see, I don't want to cut the pictures. Let's cut these two. Okay. What she's going to do? I give it a little extra dimension. Let's get funky. Yeah, so now I hope this is just a little too much. Same thing on this, also a little. I'm totally crazy. Okay, now this Let me think. Otherwise, it seems like these cars are not going anywhere. So I'm not using the letters, but I am using these. Yeah. I think that's more handy or nicer. What do you think? What do you think? Let's tumble this one. Let's see, this is coming there, and then this one. Yeah, do something funky. Yeah. Okay. This is good. Now, I peel my... Now, this is difficult because the underground is fabric, so this is not going to be easy, but it's be done. Come off. Let's see if this is handy. Yeah. Okay. Give it a little push. This time you really have to be patient with me. But we have all the time of the world. Yeah. So. In the middle, some extra glue. Okay, now there over it and here. I think this is be the white spot. Just moving everything around. Working further. Okay, I think this is going to be very, very nice. I think, yeah. And then this opens up like this. Yep, let's see how many cards there can be in. There's one, two. That can be easy, but when you have pictures on it on the back, so I think I'm going to be stopping and I just let her peeping out. So yeah, I think one more. Yeah, one more. Okay, and then the rabbit can be in here. Yeah. I think it's funny. What do you think? I like it. Do you see her peeping out? Yeah, okay. That's done. Up to the next page.